maybe here on our continent, of Africa, maybe further afield in the diaspora. You might be one of those from among us who are traveling to Turkey. I want to welcome you and wish you all the best on your trip. And for those who are joining us for training today, it's once again my pleasure to spend this evening with you, doing part of a training session on products, and hoping that you're going to stay with us, keep an open mind, listen to what we have to offer, and that we are hoping that it will be beneficial to you and your circle of influence. For those who are new, my name is Betty Olo, and I'm a long-time NeoLife distributor. Very happy to be a distributor and to be a user of these products, and also inviting you to, as a distributor or a guest, to look at our products and see how they can help in your lifestyle. So as you might have seen in your invite for today, my session is going to be about children's nutrition, specifically about their supplementation. And as always, I'll here and there try to give some extra information, because apart from distributing the products, we as NeoLife distributors always want to give any education that we can give in order to help people to have lifestyles that support good health and keep away illnesses, especially lifestyle related illnesses. So welcome everyone. And I wanted to start by saying that for all of us who are parents, I became a distributor, especially because I wanted to be able to earn an extra income to help with the needs of our growing family at the time. And for all of us who are parents, siblings, and so on, we know and hope that our children are the ones who will carry on our legacy. And so every parent knows or should know that it is important to expend time, energy, knowledge, and time, as well as resources, to prepare our children for that task. Of course, parenting work includes always helping our children to grow into self-governing adults, as well as useful members of society. And there are many things that go into parenting. On our side of NeoLife, we'll not go far afield in talking about parenting, but definitely when it comes to good nutrition and a healthy lifestyle, we as parents see this as part of our parenting work. And so this evening, we'll be talking mainly about the nutritional needs of our children at different stages. Good nutrition should, of course, always be part of our lives. But as we said last week, for those of us who are in the session, this good nutrition and good choices should already be a part of a lifestyle of everyone, and especially those who are hoping to conceive should prioritize healthy dietary and lifestyle choices even before they are expecting. And this is because, of course, maybe we have got some bad habits that we had acquired that we need to get rid of as we prepare for the baby to come. So that is why I wanted to start my session today with talking about the nutrition for expectant mothers. I touched on this last week, so I will touch on it again just to give us a base from which to go on to speaking about children's nutrition. So for expectant moms, their nutritional needs should take into account not only their own needs, but also the needs of the growing baby. Because the mother is going to be growing an entire human being from scratch. And this means that there'll be demands on her biological resources, and there might not be quite as much as is required. So supplementation in the case of expectant moms is important. Before I mention the supplements that we recommend, I also wanted to express the importance of resolving or minimizing stress in the life of the expectant mom, because as it is, the whole process of pregnancy and carrying the baby is going to be fairly stressful on the mother, and of course on the entire family, but more especially on the mother. And therefore, resolving existing stresses or minimizing them is a good way of making the path easier for the expectant mom. It's a good thing to cultivate the habit of eating wholesome foods, minimally processed, in order to start on a good food and also not to acquire health problems as the pregnancy progresses. If there is an existing lifestyle-related health issue, let us say maybe some pre-diabetes or maybe high blood pressure and such like things, it's important to make an effort to resolve these issues because they can be exacerbated as pregnancy progresses. So as you will know, we have got supplements to help in many of these lifestyle-related illnesses. And so we can help the expectant moms, if they have them, to resolve them so that they don't have this additional anxiety as they are carrying the baby. They should also look at eliminating any known toxins, whether they are environmental, for example, plastic residues, or other toxins that we know, for example, tobacco, alcohol, and any other substances that get abused for various reasons. So those should be eliminated because they would have an adverse effect on the development of the baby as well as on the health of the expectant mother. So now turning our attention to the Neolife supplements that we recommend, I want to start with multimineral alfalfa, which is our mineral preparation that is going to be very important in supplying the mineral needs of the baby's developing body, the skeleton especially, the blood and so on, and also maintaining the mom's skeleton and other tissues. Because you can imagine that when a woman is expecting, her blood circulation is going to be not only for her own needs, but also supplying the needs of the baby. So the volume of blood is going to increase, which means that she will need more blood cells, she will need more minerals. Of course, taking adequate amounts of water and other healthy fluids will be important, and so on. So multimineral plays an important role in both mother and baby. Then the next one would be vitamin B complex, which comprises of the entire B family. And as we know, when the vitamins are in a complex form, they support each other in performing their functions. And the vitamin B complex is especially important because it plays an important role in preventing the possibility of some of the birth defects and also in the development of the brain and the spinal cord. So vitamin B, very essential for expectant moms. And then the third product would be Provitality. So as we know, Provitality contains three supplements, omega-3 salmon oil, 3NN oils, and as well as multi and carotenoid complex. So looking at the individual members of Provitality, we have omega-3 salmon oil, very important for the development of the brain as well as the eye. You will remember, for those maybe who were with us at that time, we spoke about the health of the eye. And I think I mentioned that the eye is actually part of the brain. So omega-3 salmon oil will be participating not only in the development of the brain, but as well as the eye, the tissues of the eye. Then we have carotenoid complex also in Provitality, and this helps in the development of vision. So now we are now speaking about the eye as an organ of vision and the tissues and the cells that are participating, giving us the ability to see. And carotenoid complex will also help in preventing premature uterine contractions, thereby helping to avoid premature birth of the baby. So carotenoid, and there are quite a number of others, I'm just mentioning a few. And then we have 3NN, also part of Provitality, which of course, as we know, plays an important role in the overall development and good functioning of our cells. So 3NN is essential at a cellular level. It works right at the foundation. And of course, the 3NN oils also are a raw material for the making of hormones. Remember, we'll be having the hormones of the expectant mom as well as the hormones of the baby. So all these are going to be supported by 3NN. 3NN, the green matter that you see on the capsule of 3NN is actually chlorophyll, the green matter that we find in the leaves of plants. So this is what is the green color that you see on 3NN. And chlorophyll is rich in magnesium, which means when you take the 3NN, you'll also be boosting up the amount of magnesium. We'll also be getting magnesium from multi-mineral. And magnesium, together with iron and calcium, are among the most important minerals in the body. Magnesium helps in the many metabolic processes, as well as in the absorption of calcium, which we know calcium is very essential for the formation of a skeleton. So that is 3NN. And then, of course, we have got multi, which is the multivitamin that you find in Provitality. And this one is going to give us small amounts of all the different nutrients that the body requires. So Provitality is an important supplement for expectant moms. And as you can see, it's a powerhouse of a wide range of nutrients. And then for the early pregnancy, we know that expectant moms sometimes struggle with nausea. And aloe vera plus is often found to help moms who are struggling with nausea. I know that I myself, when I was expecting our youngest child, the only one who was born after we were distributors, I really relied on aloe vera plus to help me with the nausea and to prevent the nausea developing into vomiting, because sometimes it can be quite tough to maintain good nourishment when you're also struggling with nausea. Okay, so that is expectant moms. I then want to move on to the breastfeeding moms, still part of children's nutrition. I think it is well known by now that breast milk is not only the most perfect food for babies, but apart from being a food, it has got many physiological as well as emotional instructions that is carried physiologically from the mother to the child. So in the process of breastfeeding, the baby and the mother are going to be bonding. And this is good for both of them as part of the parenting task. And so as Neolife distributors, we also need to educate on the importance of breastfeeding for moms. And this means, of course, that our supplementation for the expectant mom does not end when she gives birth. We carry on during the breastfeeding process, because then, of course, extra nutrients are still going to be required to supply good quality breast milk. So we encourage breastfeeding moms to drink plenty of water, but also other nutritious fluids. For example, in many cultures, we have different kinds of broth. Some people have broth made from fish bones, some from different beef bones, and so on. So bone broth is very good for breastfeeding moms, as well as different types of nutritious soups. So this will provide good drinks to support the breastfeeding mom. And breastfeeding has another important role in that it helps the mother's body to return to the healthy body weight, as well as to shrink the uterus to its correct size. So as the breast is expressing milk, there's going to be some contraction that will be taking place. And this is the uterus actually shrinking back to its pre-birth size. Because I know I often get quite a number of questions about new moms who are looking for ways to go back to their previous body weight. And some of them have quite a struggle. And one of the ways that this can actually be helped is by breastfeeding, because often if the breastfeeding or new mom tries to go on a strict diet, what happens is that the body resists any attempts to lose weight, because it knows that there's the needs of the mom as well as the needs of the baby to take care of. So it becomes quite a struggle to lose weight, but breastfeeding is a way in which the body can actually return to pre-birth weight. The breast milk is also a very excellent foundation for the baby's immune system. And so as far as possible, we should support and educate moms to do the best they can to facilitate breastfeeding for their babies. On the side of Neolife, we then recommend that they continue with multi-mineral alfalfa, to continue providing the mineral needs of both mother and child. We also recommend NutriShake or NeoLife Shake. I think most of us now have NeoLife Shake as our protein supplement, and this supplements the good quality proteins that, of course, we'll be getting some from the diet, but also NeoLife Shake is going to be an important contribution because the proteins are going to be important for the mother also as she recovers after giving birth, but also to ensure that she has the protein she needs to also supply the milk. Then we continue with ProVitality as well for the same reasons that I had said before, because for the first 1.5 years, the omega-3 salmon oil will still be playing an important role in the development of the eyes and the brain and so on. So we continue with those supplements into the breastfeeding phase. Then now we go on to the phase of early childhood, that is toddlers, from 2 years and so. Here we recommend that we delay the introduction of sweetened foods or drinks, as well as refined starch as the first food. So these are not recommended as the first foods of the baby, because they tend to be what is called hyperpalatable. They are very tasty to the baby. And what will happen is that it might make it difficult later on to try to introduce less tasty foods, because we find that there will be different types of flavors of healthy food that the child needs to learn to like and to eat. So if we are premature in introducing sugar, sugar is a very powerful flavor, and it tends to overpower the taste buds of the child, so that when we now want to withdraw it later, it is actually quite difficult. Maybe if you are interested, you can actually take some time to find out the problems that sugar causes when it is introduced early in life. It has got to do with the poor development of teeth and a number of quite a host of other problems. So delay the introduction of sugar and sweetened foods or drinks, as well as refined carbohydrates. It is better to introduce things like mashed vegetables, mashed fruits, bone broth, even for older babies, mashed avocados, maybe mixed with bananas and so on, because these are sweet, but they're not too sweet. So that is on the lifestyle side. Then on the side of NeoLife, for this age group, we have Liquivite, which is a good baseline supplement for infants, small children. It's in a syrup form, which makes it easy for the baby to take either as a syrup or diluted in the food that the baby is being given. We can also add their NutriShake for slightly older babies, which also supplements good quality proteins for the development of the child. Then we go on to older babies. So here we are thinking about late childhood. Maybe we can speak about 5, 7 years old and so forth. Here we are again looking at good nutrition. And the nutrition plan should also involve teaching the children to eat mainly during meals and to reduce snacking, because snacking tends to be composed of very unhealthy foods. So if you see the packaged foods that are advertised as snacks, a lot of them are in fact junk. So if we are having snacks for our children, we should have good choices. So we can have fruits, and we can have non-packaged foods that the children can take if they are not yet able to remain without food between meals. But more and more, as the child grows up, we should encourage them to eat during meals. Even if they have an extra meal, we should not encourage the habit of incessant eating, because this will grow into a habit that they will have to stop later on. And you know, habits are easy, bad habits are easier to get than to get rid of. So we can start training this from this age group. We are talking about 5, 7 years old and above. So it's important to also, as I said before, help the children to develop a taste for natural foods, that is minimally processed foods, from an early stage. because then it is easier for them to develop a taste for it and not to find it unpleasant in terms of flavor or in terms of texture. Because some children struggle with foods that feel a certain way in the mouth, but if we introduce them to these different textures early, it's not going to be so unpleasant for them. As I said before, hyperpalatable junk food should be avoided as far as possible, because another thing they do is they make healthy food seem insipid or unappetizing. So then with the NeoLife products, we recommend NeoLife Shake for this age group. For protein supplementation, we recommend omega-3 salmon oil because the need for it continues, as well as Vita Squares. And we can also recommend VitaGut. So Vita Squares are a broad baseline supplement. And then VitaGut is a supplement for antioxidants. So we can have those NeoLife Shake, omega-3 salmon oil, and Vita Squares. And then VitaGut can be taken periodically, especially maybe if there's certain times of the year when the immune system needs a bit of a boost, we can then add VitaGut to the mix. Then we go on to the preteens, that is age around 11 years old. At this stage, we recommend that we start educating the children carefully about the food groups, the different food groups, so that they know that different foods perform different functions in their bodies. Of course, they may be learning this at school, but I think it is also important for them to hear this from us as parents so that they hear it from both sides. And we can also start to explain some of the health problems that are related to junk food or unhealthy food. And at this stage, we can also start thinking of encouraging them to learn how to prepare simple meals, because it is a problem these days that food which has been previously prepared, let's say packaged and bought ready-made, we often don't know all the things that are in those foods. And it is good from young people when they are able to be taught this thing, to actually start learning the basics of preparing a meal. Even if they start with simple things like sandwiches and so on, I think it is an important skill, because more and more we will see that it is important to be able to prepare our own food, because then we know what is actually in the food. So the preteens, will now be starting to use a supplement like Formula 4, which is a fairly sizable supplement. And by this time, I'm assuming that the child will already be able to swallow the capsule or the tablet supplements. And if this is a struggle, then maybe Formula 4 Plus would be better, because the Formula 4 Plus has got 3NN as a capsule, which is a slightly smaller capsule than the Formula 4 one. And it also has Multi, which is a small tablet. The only thing to remember is that Formula 4 Plus does not contain iron, and children at this age still require iron supplementation. So for that reason, if the child is struggling a lot with swallowing the Formula 4, they can continue with the Vita Squares, maybe increase the dose a little bit. But I think by this stage, we should be moving towards being able to swallow the supplements that are taken in capsule or tablet form. Then we also continue with NeoLife Shake for good quality proteins, because this is an important growth stage. The preteens are growing very fast, and they will need to supplement a good quality protein to whatever they are getting in their diet. We also continue with omega-3 salmon oil for their brain and blood health, and multi-mineral, also important. So again, multi-mineral is a large-ish supplement, so I think it would be okay to cut it in half if it's hard for the child to swallow. Multi-mineral becomes especially important as they move towards puberty, and girls start maybe experiencing menstrual flow, which means that they'll be losing some minerals every month. So multi-mineral becomes quite important. And the skeletons of boys will be enlarging, and that means that they also will need to continue with multi-mineral. If they are participating in sports and so on, we need to keep that in mind because the supplements will play an important role in supporting their sporting activities. Then I move on to the teenage. So here we go on recommending the education on healthy eating and also learning to prepare meals, helping to prepare meals maybe during the school holidays so that they get better at doing it. By the time they are reaching mid-teens, they should actually be able to prepare their meals because this is a useful skill to carry on with them when they grow up and leave home. One of the things that I noticed with our own young men is that there was a problem of putting on quite a bit of weight after leaving home as a result of indulging a little bit too much in fast foods and packaged foods. So sometimes when you speak to the young ones, they don't really take it seriously. But once they start realizing they are getting piling on quite a bit of weight, they start realizing that there was actually important reasons why we were discouraging them from habitually eating fast foods and prepackaged foods. So the education there is quite important. And also educating them on the reasons for supplementation. So they need to know why it is that Neolife prepares these supplements and what role they play in good health. So again, here we'll continue with Formula 4. We'll go on with multi-mineral as well as Nutrishake. We may also add vitamin B complex here for the provision of energy because sometimes the teens are growing so fast that they become lethargic as a result of the demands the body's growth is having on them. So we may need to supplement with vitamin B complex also for the teenagers. Then I see I have a minute or two remaining. I wanted to tackle a question that is related to young people, and that is acne. So acne is an inflammation driven skin condition that affects the oil producing glands in the skin, as well as the cells that grow hair out of our skins, the follicles, the hair follicles that is on our skins. So we nowadays seem to almost accept that acne has to be a part of teenage, but I think that many of us who are older know that not everybody actually had acne when they were growing up. And in fact, even now when you go to rural areas, you'll find that if there are areas where these modern types of food are not easily accessible, you still find that acne in adolescent is actually not a prevalent thing. So there is a connection between these unhealthy food choices and the appearance of acne. Of course, also hormonal changes that are associated with adolescence will contribute to making the skin a bit more reactive. And the problem is sometimes when the skin is reacting as a result of these hormonal changes, then there may be an idea that they should use harsh cleansers to clean the skin, but this further irritates the skin, so it is not a good idea. And so what we recommend in Neolife is that they make good food choices, they use the supplements that we speak about, and for cleaning the skin, to use gentle makeup remover in the evening, because this is a very gentle cleanser that does not strip the skin and does not irritate the skin. Then they can apply aloe vera gel. If they have oily skin, aloe vera gel will be adequate. If they tend to have dry skin, they may need to add a bit of glycerin, just the normal glycerin you get in the shops, to the aloe vera gel to make it less drying, because if the skin is dry, aloe vera gel tends to be a bit too light. Then we can add zinc and vitamin A plus D. So those can help with acne. But if you're taking the supplements using this skincare of aloe vera gel and gentle makeup remover, it is pointless to do that and then go on to eat foods that are going to aggravate the gut. Because remember, I've mentioned before that the gut and the skin on our bodies are actually the same type of tissue. The skin is continuous into our gut. And if our gut, which has a much bigger surface area, than the skin that covers our body. If the gut is being aggravated, the aggravation is most likely also going to show on the skin. And maybe when there is a bit more sparkling skincare, we shall be looking at some of the skin problems that originate in problems to do with the gut. But now just to say that apart from using the products, it is important to avoid inflammatory foods. Here we are thinking about sugary food, sodas. I know that teenagers tend to be very fond of sodas, and many juices today are not really much better than soda. They seem to me to be more like a soda with a picture of a fruit on it. So to encourage these young people to drink plain water, which is a very good drink once you're used to it. And as I said, it's better to start these habits young. So I think today I'm going to stop at that point, the half hour. And Pascal is standing by with the next session on the business. I want to thank you very much. I know that we have been in the midst of month end. I hope that it is going well and you're reaching your goals. And I want to encourage you to keep pushing, because success in our business does not happen to us alone. Whenever we are succeeding in our business, it means that we have made a positive difference in someone's life. And that is always a good thing. And so I want to encourage myself and you, all of you as well, that we go out there and do what we do best, which is to make the world a healthier, wealthier, and happier place. Thank you very much. Here is Pascal now to take you through the next session.
Thank you very much, Betty. I think the session on children is very important, because the future of our business is in the children. So when you build our business, I know there are some families in Neolife that are business are in the third generation. A friend of mine who lives in Pretoria is called Kaz Wilsenach. His father was one of the founders of one of the first distributors in South Africa in Neolife. And he took over his father's business, and now his children are also in the business. So I think we need to take good care of
Hansi also.
Our mentor and Hansi Cronier, his daughters are in the business. I think one of them has become a director already. So this is a really exciting business that you can actually hand down to your children when it is well built. And that means they need to have good nutrition, good parenting, and so that your business is assured of the future. What I want to share with you this evening are two things. One is retailing products. Why is retailing products important? It's important because remember what our business is. Our business is moving products from Neolife to various customers. Some of those customers are ourselves. Some of those customers are our friends and relatives who are not in the business. So if you'll allow me, I want to share the screen with you. So retailing products. Why is retailing products very important? Because we only get paid when we move products from Neolife to different customers. That is how we are paid in the business. Now, remember the three daily success habits. What are those three daily success habits? Number one is using the product ourselves. Number two is sharing the business and the products. So sharing the products is the same as retailing products. So what are the essential things that are important in retailing products? The first thing I want to mention is your goal is to do 100 points every single month. If you're a distributor, you've been in the business for a long time, after this training session, sit down, find out how many people are in your team. If everybody in your team just did 100 points, your business would triple. Just 100 points. Okay? So, and how do you make sure your team does 100 points? You must do your 100 points yourself first. When you do that, the people in your team will duplicate or copy what you do. I find this disconcerting, but everything you do in your business, people in your team will do, whether they are with you or not. I have seen this working over and over again in our business. If you don't sponsor people, your team does the same. If you sponsor many people, your team does the same. If you do 100 PV consistently, your team is going to do the same. So, what are the essential things about retailing products? Step number one is product knowledge. I think after the fantastic session Betty has done, you have a very good idea of which products to recommend for children's nutrition, okay? So the first step about retailing products is product knowledge. Once you have the product knowledge, the next thing is listening to customers or listening to people. Maybe you have a family meeting or a family get together, and one of the parents or one of the people are complaining that my mother has had arthritis for such a long time, or high blood pressure, or my dad has had prostate problems, whatever it is. If you're listening carefully, what they're actually telling you, I need your help. I need your help to sort this situation, because we are paid for solving people's problems. That's why we were paid. So listening to what people are saying will give you an opening for you to recommend the products. Let me say you've got a friend who has been having high blood pressure for a long time. And they tell you, look, I've been having high blood pressure for the last 6 years, and I take high blood pressure medication every single day. They have got so many side effects. Sometimes I feel dizzy. Sometimes I feel I'm going to faint. I'm so sick and tired of it. That's not the time to jump in and recommend the products. Prod more and find out more information. How long has this been? Does that affect your work life? Ask questions. Don't ask closed-ended questions. Ask open-ended questions. How? Why? If you ask those questions, they will open themselves up. They'll give you a lot of information that you need to be able to recommend the products. When they have done so, then you recommend, by the way, I think I've got something that may help. You've got a product called omega-3, which is a fish oil that helps the prevention of cholesterol, which turns into plaque that makes high blood pressure worse. And I have something called lipotropic that helps to reduce high blood pressure. Maybe you can try those two products, okay? Because remember, people are looking for solutions to their challenges of their problem. So step number one is product knowledge. Step number two is listening. Step number three is recommending products to customers. And when you've sold the products to them, after 1 week, keep in touch with them. Call and find out how they are doing in the products. How are they? And then keep records on when they bought the product so that you know when to get in touch with them if they need additional products. And then get to know your customers. Find out who they are, find out their birthdays, find out information about their life so that you keep in touch with them. Okay? And then give a personal touch. You see, when people go to buy things from a retail shop, there is no personal touch. That's what makes our business very unique. So keep a personal touch, enthusiasm, ask questions and listen. I mean, the reason why we have two eyes and two ears and one mouth is so that we can listen more than we speak, okay? Keep records, share literature with your customers. I used to hear Alta Bolton used to say, where literature goes, products flow. So get these small leaflets of different products, share them with your customers. Smile a lot. I mean, smiling, in fact, try this in the street tomorrow. Just look at a stranger and smile at them. They will smile back at you. They may get surprised that you're smiling at them, but smiling has got a very magical effect on people. Then use the customer's name often. Why do you do that? So that you can actually remember their name, because one of the things that people really appreciate is when the people who sell things to them remember their names. Okay, so those are some issues that you can help your retail products. Your goal is to do at least 100 PV from your own use and the customers that you supply to. Think about this. One tree and N is 17 PV, 60 capsules. Chelated Calmac is 12 PV. Omega-3 Salmon Plus, the small one, is 16 PV. Let me say you use those products only. That's already 46 or 47 PV. Look for two other customers, you've already done your 100 PV. That is as simple as it is, but you need to keep searching for people who are looking for our products and people who you can listen to solve their problems. That's how you build a customer base to be able to do your 100 PV. And then you teach your team to do exactly what you do. But why do you need to do 100 PV? You need to do 100 PV, and that leads you to the next step. And the next step is taking your steps to become a director. Aim to become a director. Number one, using a product, doing 100 PV. As you develop customers, eventually you'll have enough customers to be able to do 250. But the foundation is 100 PV. Next step is you sponsor new people into the business and help them to do what you've just done. That is, help them to retail products. That means ask them to give you a list of people. And when they meet people with different situations or different conditions, they will ask you, by the way, I've got somebody who's got this challenge. What products can I recommend? Then you give them the information. And the idea is for them to learn. Once you become a manager, your next step is develop other managers so that you become a senior manager. When you become a senior manager, your next step is to become an executive manager. An executive manager is somebody who is doing 2,000 PV with their team, but at least 100 in your own name. If you've got 4 executive managers, you're a director. And what is the goal? The goal is to repeat this same process. It takes time. It takes patience. It takes persistence to be able to succeed in doing this. The reason why you're in the business is to make money. You're going to make money if you provide a service or a product to somebody else. Now, I remember when we got started in the business, we were so desirous of building a team. But as our business grew, we realized that your success will only be guaranteed if the people in your team actually take their steps and become successful. So remember that your success is linked to the number of people you help to become successful. The more you give of your time and your knowledge and your love, the more successful you're going to become. And if you keep doing that, your business will grow and you'll start making the steps that are necessary to become a successful person in our business. Every month, now that the month of April is over, the new month is beginning tomorrow. Set your goals for the month of May. The first step, you need to know where you are. If you're a new distributor, the first step is do 100 PV. 3 goals you need to set. Number one, set the goal of the personal PV you want to do. Okay? Personal PV. At least 100 PV. Number two, set the goal of the personal sponsoring, the number of people you want to introduce to the business so that you can help them become successful. Number three, the step you want to take. If you're a distributor, your step is to become a qualified distributor or become a manager. If you're a manager, your next step is to become a senior manager. If you're a senior manager, your next step is to become an executive manager. If you're an executive manager, your goal is to become a director. Okay? But you have to plan it. You need to take a pen, write down your plans for the new month. If every person in your team writes a plan for the new month, and then they have a reliable daily method of operation, you will achieve your goals. Our business is very simple. It takes you to, first, you need to know this is a business. If you treat the business as a hobby, you'll get hobby income. If you treat it as a serious business, I mean, this morning I was sending a friend of mine in Nairobi some information about our industry. In 2021, this industry generated $187 billion. That's how big our industry is. The question is, do you want a small percentage of that $187 billion? It starts with a simple, small step of getting started in the business, doing 100 PV, sponsoring new people into the business, 2 to 3 every month, and then planning your next step. If you keep doing that over and over again, your business will grow. And why is that important? The next thing that is important is to be persistent. There is no success without persistence. And persistence is important because our business is not a get-rich-quick business. It's a business that requires sustained effort. I was speaking to a friend of mine from Italy yesterday. I think it is yesterday. And I was telling her, you know, in the rural areas, you have a water pump that when you dig a well, you turn that water pump so much, and nothing seems to be coming out. But for water to come out, you need to keep doing that until it starts flowing by itself. That is a similar thing that happens in our business. You will work sometimes and you don't seem to be seeing any growth or success coming, but you need to keep the sustained effort. Now, persistent is a state of mind. A state of mind that says, I'll keep doing what I need to do every single day to make sure our business grows. Will you see the immediate result? No. It takes a whole growing season. Remember the three laws that our business follows. Number one, the law of sowing and reaping. If you talk to people, you'll get some who want to do the business. Number two, the increasing returns. If you sow one seed, you will not harvest one. Otherwise, why would you sow it if you only harvest one? You're going to harvest a whole bushel. So sowing and reaping, the law of increasing returns, and the law of delayed gratification. It simply means that you're working now, but you're not expecting immediate results. You're expecting your results after a whole growing season. So the state of mind of persistence. Persistence is a state of mind. Number two, it is a sustained effort towards a worthwhile goal. And that means it has to come from your strength of your will. Remember, this is actually a choice. Are you going to get obstacles? Definitely. Will you get people who are going to discourage you? Yes. The key thing is, what is your goal? What is your desire? Start with a definite aim or goal. I think having a definite goal is very critical because if you sustain a goal in your mind for so long, it will find expression in reality. The other day I was speaking to one of our children and a thought occurred to me that from the principle of conservation of matter, you cannot create or destroy matter. All the matter in the world has already been created in one form or another. So, this laptop I'm speaking through, or if you have a smartphone that you're using to attend this meeting, that device, first of all, started in the imagination of somebody. And that somebody knew the properties of the material you need to use to make that device. And that leads to a very important element of using your imagination to create a goal or a definite aim in your future or your life. Number four, you need to have an intense desire. A desire is not a wish. A desire is something that pulsates in your heart and your mind constantly. You need to have a very intense desire for you to succeed. You need to have definite plans because it is not enough to have a desire. It's not enough to have goals. It's not enough to have a strong will. You need to have definite plans to achieve the goals that you want. And then you need to have accurate knowledge of the thing that you want. Let me give you an example. For example, you want to become a world team member. You want to become a Sapphire director. Okay? Oh, by the way, I want to congratulate Martha Njanja for becoming a brand new Sapphire director in the Kenyan market. So these things can be done. Martha, congratulations. So you need to have a very accurate knowledge of what you really want. You need to have accurate knowledge of what you need to do to make that become a reality. You need to have knowledge of who you are. Self-knowledge is one of the keys to success. And then you need to have definite daily activity habits. We are creatures of habits. Aristotle says that success is not a destination. Success is actually a habit. Okay, so if you want to succeed, you need to develop successful habits. Successful habits simply mean the things you do every day to lead you to your goal. Will you achieve them every day? No. The thing is, it has to be a sustained effort. And that's where persistence comes in. If you keep persisting in what you want to achieve, nothing will stop you from becoming successful. Nothing will slow you down. You may get a bump. You may sometimes get derailed. People will tell you all sorts of things, but you need to keep your eyes on the goal. I remember when I was a child, we used to play with magnifying glasses. And we would put it and put the sun. And if you put the magnifying glass steady, it will burn into the paper. But if you keep moving the magnifying glass, you will not get any heat. The same is this business, the same is life. Focus. If you focus on what you want, success will follow. So, ladies and gentlemen, those are the few things Betty and I wanted to share with you this evening. First is the things that you, the nutrition for children. Number two, then you need to know how to retail products. And that comes from having product knowledge, listening to your customers, and offering a solution, and then keeping in touch with your customers so that every time the customer wants to buy products, who do they think about? It's you. And then you need to develop persistence. Persistence is a state of mind. It means you need to always go after what you want. It takes discipline. It needs you to have a specific goal that you're going after. You need to have a vision, have daily disciplined habit. And if you do that, the goal you're going after will become a reality. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. We appreciate you spending this evening with us. Alan, thank you so much for hosting our meeting today. And we wish everybody the best of May to achieve the goals you set for the month of May. Thank you and good night.